In this video, I will go over proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed number, and also how to change back and forth between an improper fraction and a mixed number, and vice versa. Now, first, fraction in general, which is made up and it's written in this format, we know that A, the numerator, which is on top, and B, the denominator, which is at the bottom, they must be integers. And for those who have forgotten, so integers can be negative, positive, or the number zero. This is the set of integers. So they go on, obviously, forever in both directions. Now, the only thing to remember that in the denominator, our b is not allowed to be zero, but it can be any other integer than that. So, proper fraction. If you want to be able to distinguish between a proper fraction or an improper fraction, because we write fractions in the format of A over B, what makes this fraction proper is simply the fact that A, the numerator on top, must be smaller than the denominator at the bottom. For instance, 1 over 2 would be a proper fraction because 1 is smaller than 2. 4 over 11, again, is a proper fraction. 4 is smaller than 11. 7 over 20 is a proper fraction. But if you wanted to, for instance, write 7 over 3, now notice that 7 is bigger than 3. This would not be a proper fraction, but it brings about now the definition for improper fraction. Improper fraction is any fraction where now the A is bigger or equal to B. For instance, the 7 over 3, that is an improper fraction because A is bigger than B. Now, 7 over 7 is also an improper fraction because of the fact that they can be equal. So this works as well. 11, 2 is improper. And I believe that you get the gist of what the difference between a proper fraction and an improper fraction is. Now, finally, the last item, which is a mixed number. For mixed numbers, it is a combination of two numbers. So, for instance, you have a natural number or a whole number in front, and it is combined with a proper fraction. So here, this is a natural, which is a counting number, natural or a whole number. And this is a proper fraction. Let me give you some examples so that you can distinguish. For instance, 1 3/4 would be a mixed number. It's composed of a whole component and of a proper fraction. Now be careful, because if, for instance, you had something like this, this is a whole component, but this is an improper fraction. So that would not be considered a mixed number. So this would be neither of the three: proper, improper, or mixed number. So now, next, okay, if we had, we're given 7 and 1 over 11, this would be considered a mixed number because it's a whole component or natural plus a proper fraction. Now, the meaning here, this is the short way of writing 1 plus 3 over 4. That's what this really means, but we skip the addition and we bring them together so that it's a little bit more compact and easier to write. But it means the same exact thing. Now, lastly, what happens if you want to, for instance, change back and forth between an improper fraction and a mixed number? Let's do that now. So improper fraction and a mixed number, which you may have to do at some instances. So if we're going in this direction, and if we take an improper fraction, so here's some examples. If I had 7 over 3, which is improper, and I wanted to change it to a mixed number, then what I would do is I would divide the numerator, which is on top, by the denominator. So what I'm asking is, how many times does 3 go into 7? And you will notice that 3 goes into 7 2 times, and you will have a remainder of 1, which means the 2 is your whole component, and then your remainder goes on top, while your denominator stays the same. So 7/3 is equal to 2 1/3 as a whole number. Now, if you wanted to go in reverse in this direction, then you can take a mixed number, say 4 3/11, and now in this case, well, remember what this means, 4 plus 3 over 11. So what we like to do in this example is we want to know our whole component. If we broke it down into a fraction, how many pieces would it give us? So we take these two and we multiply them to see, okay, if we had 11 pieces, but we had 4 whole of them, so 4 times 11, that would be from my whole component, and then I still have 3 left over, so in total, 4 times 11 is 44, plus 3 is 47, so I would have 47 pieces, okay, and my denominator stays the same. This is going from a mixed number into an improper fraction. So you can change back and forth in between them. I do want to show you one more example, and that example deals with this, which was not a mixed number, but I just want to show you how would you change it to, say, a mixed number. So let me take this example, which was 2 5/3. Now, if you want to make this fraction, okay, into a mixed number, so if you take, because it's an improper fraction, so you will notice that 3 goes into 5 1 time, and you have a remainder of 2, and the denominator stays the same, which is 3. So what you have now is you have 2 whole components plus 1 whole component, so in total you have 3 whole components, and you have the fraction, which would be 2/3. So 2 5/3 is equal to 3 2/3. Now this is a mixed number, but this was not a mixed number. But you can change it if you would like. So that is an example of that. Now, I can give you another example. Let's say if we had 1, say 11 over 2. And if you want to change this, notice it's not a mixed number, but if you wanted to change it to a mixed number, again, I can take 11 over 2, change it to a mixed number. So 2 goes into 11 5 times. I have a remainder of 1. My denominator stays the same. And now I have 1 whole component plus 5 whole components, which is 6. And I have my fractional component, which is the proper fraction, 1 over 2. That's how you would change it back. If you wanted to change it to an improper fraction, of course, you can do that entirely by simply saying 2 times 6, which is 12, plus the 1, which is 13, over 2. So this is mixed format. This is improper. So we have gone over in this video proper fraction, improper fraction, and a mixed number. Proper fraction, the numerator is smaller. Improper fraction, the numerator is bigger or equal. And a mixed number is made up of a whole component plus a proper fraction. Thank you for watching.